Hello guys, welcome back. I'm Naveen, and in today's video we're going to see how to deactivate all of your plugins when you can't access WP admin or administrative menu. So I will go to my site. Here you can see my site is experiencing some technical issues because I have installed, updated and some plugins and themes in my website, and suddenly this issue appear and I don't know which plugin causing this issue. So I want to check one by one, or I just want to deactivate all of my plugin. So my developer suggested me this way, and now what should I do? Because when I go to WP admin, I'm getting the same error. This site is experiencing technical issue. But here you can read one more sentence: please check the site admin email address. So this is the one of the way by which you can recover your website from that faulty plugin. So recently WordPress has launched this feature where WordPress send email to site admin email address whenever some issues or error or something uncertain happened with your website. So here I got an email from WordPress and with a link, you can see. So I will go, you can read this. Okay, since 5.2 and fatal short notice, so I will click on this link because this link will move me to my admin panel. So here I have to log in with my login details, and now I'm in recovery mode, so I can access my admin panel as I access it before. So I go to plugins, and here you can see WordPress has already highlighted the plugin that causing the issue, and with mentioned issues that WordPress has stated that this plugin is causing issue because of this. So you can deactivate this plugin and your website will work as expected. I will exit the recovery mode, and now when I refresh my page, here you can see my website is up. So this is one of the way through which you can detect or just deactivate the plugin that causing the issue. And another second way that we're going to see, because sometimes you are not the real admin, the key administrative we can see, or sometimes you don't have the site admin email address access. Maybe you lost it, or maybe something else happened, I don't know, but there may be a case. So now we will move to the second point, but for that we have to create that issue again. So I will do that stuff with a magic. So here we have the issue again, and now we have to fix this issue without using the admin the email that WordPress has sent to us. So how we can do that? Now for that we have to deactivate all plugins manually. But Naveen, don't you know that we can't access our administrator panel? That we know that issue. So how now? So there are two ways to deactivate your plugins now. One, by using FTP. So you can, if you have FTP access, you can just go to FileZilla or maybe any other software, and you can just log in with your FTP details, and there we will find all of your file. Or you can just go to your hosting cPanel. So here I have my hosting. This website is set up on Hostinger. So I'll go to my file manager. So I just clicked on the file manager thing, and here my site name appear. I will go to OK, open the cPanel manager, file manager, and here we go. Here we have all the files. So I will go to WP admin and then plugins, and here we have the list of plugin. But again, I don't know which plugin causing this issue. So what I will do, either I will deactivate one by one, or I will just go here and rename this thing to old or deactivated, or maybe anything you can rename it. As soon as you rename it from plugins, you go to your administrative manual and refresh it. Okay, here you go. Here you can see that your all plugin gone. So now again go back to the same thing and just rename it back to plugins, the actual directory name. And now I will refresh the plugin plugin page, and here we go. Here we have all the plugin deactivated. Now what we can do, we can activate plugins one by one, and as soon as we get okay, this plugin is causing the issue, we can delete it, or we can just permanently deactivate that plugin. So now I will activate both of the plugins, and as soon as I activate it, okay, I got a fatal error. So this error was causing the issue, and this error was from custom buddy pro at line number 11. Okay, so this plugin is causing the issue. So I will go here, and forgot, I will not deactivate this plugin, and I will move with the other plugin that I have. I will activate them, and I will just enjoy my WordPress journey. So that's how it is very easy to deactivate your all plugins when you have, and to troubleshoot your website things. And I'm going to come up with a video where I will show the troubleshooting step in detail, that how you can troubleshoot your website when some error occurs on in your website, and how you can, you know, catch the error without going to any developer, or you can fix with your own. So with just few easy steps. So stay connected. If you like my video, please like and subscribe to my channel, and as always, thank you so much.